Well, I didn't really have a gift ready, so,
Well,
here we go. Unlimited stadium.
Really?
It'll never, ever run out.
Really?
So, see you later.
I'm not going any faster! You took away my sprint?! But why? That jerk? He's like, I hate you. So I feel like there's more of a story to that restaurant, but since I was just sprinting through out of fear because of those bulls, I'm never gonna know what it is. I also wonder what they're gonna send at me now that they took away my sprint. I should probably be more worried that they took away my sprint. I probably should be. I just hit a wall with my ass. On the upside, now that I have no stamina, she's right on one point. I have infinite axe. However, I don't have run, which in many cases was more important. So yeah. You know, part of me is sitting here going like, man, I sure hope I never see, you know, this monster again. Then I can sit here and go, wait. So what monsters are they gonna send at me then? It's like, ooh, maybe I do want those monsters back because I at least understand how they work. Kind of. I mean somewhat. I mean, the only one I don't really understand how it works is the little... Oh, nice. The only one I really don't understand how it works is the little girl. And that's just because she appeared out of nowhere and ate me. And I became a baby. And I became her baby. Literally, I somehow became her baby. That or she's misunderstanding the difference between stomach and womb. I don't know if that's actually something chasing me, but I don't want to look at it because there's like nothing. There's only one thing that makes a difference when you look at it, and I know what it sounds like, and this doesn't sound like that, so I'm just going to keep running and assume whatever it is chasing me that I'm going to die, and this is how. Show up at a save point at 800. That'd be convenient. Alright, go. Yep, we're on the home run. Not the home run. Fog again. Ah, cleavage lady. Why, cleavage lady? Thank you. Just like she just started walking away from me, so I was like, hey! I got an axe! What you got? Oh, a cleaver! Or a giant machete? So like, machete? Sharp, strong, sad. That's what I need. I need more Homestar Runner Marathon. I just like that. It's like, with a machete? How do you say, like, machete? Oh crap, am I moving forward? Okay. I was like, I can't tell if I'm actually moving forward or not. That's not a good sign. Not a good sign at all. Noticing there's also no noise to play anymore, which I'm actually okay with. Yeah, I'm cool. You cool? Cool. So, yeah. Come on, there we go. Yes, keep that blood pumping. You can do it. We can help, Papa John's. Wait a second, isn't that Home Depot's theme? You can do it. We can help. Oh, button. And whatever. I got a save spot. So, do. Like, suck it. Now that I escaped the alien that had to be my friend, I need to babysit it. Life saves days good. I think this video has gone on at least for 2 hours now. Yeah, so, this last segment has only been 36 minutes, but I think it's been going on for at least 2 hours now. So, suck it. It is jerk, suck it, yeah. So, what creepy abominations are gonna come after me now? Or is it just gonna be more cleavage lady? I mean, like, if it is gonna be more cleavage lady, just tell me. I'm cool with that. Because it's cleavage lady. I understand how she works. Shadow Gooby guy has to come and hit me up a good one, and then it does nothing, but somehow locks doors. He probably just, like, bonks me on the nose or something. Oh, what? So I just had to keep hitting the door? Oh, is that it? I just keep hitting the door until it lets me through? Nice noise. That makes it easier. That makes it way easier. Well, feels like we've hit dungeon. We've hit good old medieval. This mansion is strange. I think the bricks would actually just paint on. Everything still feels kind of fake. Also, keep your movement voice fully. Maybe this fires are down here. I want a pepper. I wanted a pepper. What's this? Bedroom key. Oh, cool. Oh, this is where I was. Broken. Okay. Well. So I'm stuck in room. So 10 is what is this? Wow, 1 minute inside another. Maybe I've made it all the way to the end of the house. Maybe this is like a resting place or another entrance. Perhaps part of the case. I think this is a good spot to rest. So I've noticed that like 10 after whatever the main one is. This place is an illusion. 10 after whatever the save point is seems to be the norm for, what's this? I can hide inside of it? Hide from what, though? So, my gut instinct.
Are you in here? Are you in here?
No! No one's home! You must have dropped a key. I was about to say, it's like, so my first instinct is just to, you know, say screw it and go. But I don't know if I'll hear him even when he's not here. It's like he isn't even real, but somebody fears me. Let me in. I sure hope he's not gonna, like, randomly pop up at me, because that would suck. I mean, he appears to only be in places that I can, like, hide in. So I just gotta find, I found the bedroom. Oh, man, this place is looping on itself. Or at least I feel like it is. Ah, it's broken. Broken, okay, cool. What? Oh, come on. What? What? Max, who is an idiot. I can hear him coming, that's all I need to hide, but I don't know. I think he's outside the door. Can I, like, sneak behind here? Come on. Come on, seriously? Okay, fine, I'm just gonna leave. Screw it, I'm out. I didn't see a key, I didn't see anything. Maybe it's cause, like, since I got his key, from him on accident, you know? That sound got there. I have to, like, find whatever certain room it is, and then you'll start hearing the noise, and then it'll be like, okay, you need to hug. So I don't know what I'm doing wrong. If I'm doing anything wrong, it was just getting here. Now it's just I really hope he doesn't kill me, because this is weird. And I'm going to have to figure it out again. Bedroom, right? Bedroom. I've been in here, though. Where is this one? It's stalking me. Something, something. So let me in here, though. It's just E. Alright, fine, whatever. This is weird. I'm confused and stupid. Not a good combination. Yeah, give me a second, guys. See if I can find my way out. Oh, wait, hang on. Library. I don't see anything. Key picked up. Cool. Sure hope he doesn't come in here because there's nowhere to hide. I know where to go though. It's like, you didn't see it. It's like, are you here? No. No, I'm not. Here. There's a manifest stalking me. You're okay. Manifest destiny. Where the crap am I supposed to go? Why is the area turning red? Why is the fog red? I'm feeling really okay. Back here.
Where are you?
Strikes me I don't even need to do anything other than just don't hit spacebar for Pete's sake. No. I'm like, so am I good? Oh, there he is. He's like twitching a little bit. You guys see that? Staying a little bit, just be safe. Alright, cool. Maybe he's behind the one possible hiding spot. These bots. Oh no, he'd never be behind that. That'd be stupid. Why would he need a fake book? I can play a tune. Maybe he just needs some soft music in his life. I'm like 100% lost, man. Oh, book. Nice. Let me in. Okay. This was a good plan. I sure hope he's not like, oh, my secret cubbyhole. My secret wine cellar. I don't know. What do creepy people keep in their cellars? Well, Max, it's a very open-ended question. I have a theory. I think it's a pseudo mansion. I think it's playing with my head. I still hear him. I must find that man and kill him with the sickle I found in the forest. Why can't I step over these mountains? Wait, with the sickle? He had a sickle. Or a scythe. Many times it's debatable if it's called a sickle or a scythe, because, I mean, scythes are like bigger and straighter blade, while sickles are more curved. And he had something that was built like a scythe, but it had a more curved blade. But I wouldn't call it a sickle. Or Max, are you trying to identify his weapon? Yes. Depending on his weapon, depends on how I fight him. Got it. Where's the exit, by the way? I never found the exit door. I don't have to do anything. Oh, dude, he's like right there. And twitching. Oh, wait, hold on. I have to find him. Oh, the guy, that's the guy who... That's the guy who's writing the notes. Because he thinks he's seen something crazy. He's like, I found a sickle in the forest. I'm going to kill him with it. But first, I got to find him. So, yeah, that's him. Of course, if he sees me, no doubt he's going to start going... you're him. No, I'm not. You're him. He kills me. Well, you weren't him. I'm going to keep looking for all eternity. Yeah, where's the exit? I don't know if that was ever firmly established. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. I'm actually surprised how calm I was. Like, I'm not trying to say it to be like, oh, look at me. No, it's just kind of like a... I didn't freak out. It's just kind of like, oh, stinking jerk. Ah, good, good. But it's just kind of like an, oh, dang it. Oh, he's chasing me. Hey, look, I'm your... Okay. He's like, I'm your friend. Okay, I don't think he's buying that. Sorry, Bill. Once again, half-second delayed reaction time. I keep looking at my camera here. Once again, you're here. I'm looking down there. Ah, well, sounds like he's still dragging the thing, so we just gotta keep on trekking along, and hopefully he doesn't, like, summon anything to come and kill me, or else that would suck on ice. That also took forever to do, so I'm really keen on the whole not dying escapade. If I could just not die. If I could just not get jump scared by stupid stuff. That'd make me so happy. Go 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 go. Are you still chasing me, by the way, man? I'm going to assume yes. Judging by that noise, yes. Hey dude, are you still chasing me? He's like, dude, stop. Dude, it's unnecessary. Look, I'm not here. I'm not here to hurt you or anything. Let's just be cool about this, okay? Let's just be cool. Dang it, ice cream! Let's just try to be friends, okay? Look, I mean you no harm. You mean me no harm, I think. So we're all good, right? I'd say we're all good. I'd say we're all just dandy. We're all just best buds, YouTubers. We're all just best buds. Just best buddy friends. Can I go home now? Shut up, you are here. Man, I really hope this is a save point soon. I want there to be a save point. I don't want to play arcane games. I don't know what's chasing me, but I hear breathing. And it's not my breathing. Do you know how funny that'd be if in a game they're like, music could change. But, it was like you kept hearing horse breathing, and they're like, oh, it must be the thing! And it's like you and him breathe the. Let's check this. But like you and him breathe the same, or at least it sounds the same. Oh, that'd be so messed up. It'd be like, what the? Back, an old Victorian mansion that seems to build itself around its environment, especially when someone chooses to host to possess and use them to detect subjects with various means depending on the house characters. Not much is known about the origin of the mansion, but signs occasionally show an earlier massacre or tragedy has taken place in the mansion. But various souls turn out to be a reliable method of extraction. Oh, so you are trying to extract souls. Oh. Max, that was kind of obvious, was it? Oh, wait, hold on, wait, that's not a little girl. Hold, drowning? What? An ancient water-dwelling creature believed to be a lost soul who died tragically during the deluge. What the deluge? Proved extremely effective against subjects that could not swim or fell from the subject's lure. Lure? You don't say. You know what this translates to? What? We're dealing with mermaids. You wanna know the trick to killing a mermaid? What? Don't fall for its crap and stay out of hand's reach. Just shoot it. Or arrow it. Whatever. It's like, whatever. The point remains, don't get near it. I always love that where people have like modern depictions of mermaids and like these beautiful creatures. Has anyone seen that one movie? I forget. Ah, cleavage lady. It's cleavage lady again. I forget. Ah, that guy again. Is it called? Not at World's End. Ah, man, the fourth Pirates of the Caribbean movie? That was freaky. But, the fourth Pirates of the Caribbean movie? The one where they have mermaids? I thought that was actually a kind of good representation of them. I just wish they got scarier. Like, I mean, they already were pretty freaky, like, don't get me wrong. But, I wish they had, like, bigger, pointier teeth. I remember seeing this one depiction. And it was basically like, you see like a beautiful woman, and all of a sudden her head turns into like this giant piranha mouth. It was just like, oh, let me reference 15 things. What's the name of that one ship from Mortal Kombat? Like the purple lady who always has her mouth covered, and then it actually opens, and she's like, That was like the level that this depiction of a mermaid was at. It was just freakish. And I was like, holy crap, that's awesome. That's pretty, yeah, that's, that be it. James is freaking me out. Stop that. I like how it makes me stop that a little bit. Like, I'm sprinting, and it's just like, you know, if you get caught by the jump scare, you have to, like, stop that a little bit. You go like, I don't know what's going on. Or if that's actually just the sound of cleavage lady, but, I don't even think it's a lady. He's like, I don't even think it's a lady. Well, the joke started with cleaver, because cleavage and lady, so, yeah. Now, if any of you ever play this game after me, which, as I said, I encourage, then you will all forever refer to her as cleavage lady. It's like, I know the cleavage lady! Did I name anyone else? There's Squid Gee and Squid Bee. Squid Bee was the evil one. That's why he's called B, because, you know, it's like, you know, you got like out, like you got the A one and the B one, Squid Bee. Do you get the joke? It was a clever pun I made. I thought it was clever. I even made it up on like the like spur of the moment, then I realized the pun that I made on accident. I was like, look at me, you're smart. Who's like, I'm sorry. Crap. Yeah, mermaids are terrifying. Then depending on like what depiction or like what video game, movie, lore, mythology you want to go in, sometimes they have super strength. And now I know it's like, you know, at least strength enough where a bunch of them could tip a bunch of them could destroy a boat. Or at least tip it. Or at least grab people and pull them in, like you saw in the Pirates of the Caribbean movie. They had like these seaweed whips. Yeah, terrifying. I got no one's chasing me, but I only got a few more floors. Then I'm at 900. And there should be a save point because I don't want to go through the mansion again. Because that was Skull. I thought they were gonna show some giant gargantuan monster. Hang in there! Are you in here? Max? His, Max? Max, are you okay? Max? Max, stop, you go kitchen. Look at, you know how hard, he's like holding it like this. So it's like, that would require an insane amount of strength. To just hold yourself there for like a minute, for like 10 seconds even, that would just be like, can't imagine doing that. I have like no upper body strength, as I've proven, because not this nonsense again, just like straight off the bat, hey, remember all those good times we had? Yeah, let's have some more. Oh, yep, you still fired me. I was like, wait, maybe it's a puzzle room. Nope, it's not a puzzle room. It's not a puzzle room. Ah, come on. Oh, no. Research report 1. More whales are being shipped to the facility tomorrow. One for a health inspection, two that are already dead for autopsies. More and more beach whales keep peering around these islands. Still can't find what is causing it. Oh, the mermaid must have caused it. Okay, this is disturbingly dark. But on the upside, I don't have to deal with who's your nose. Yeah, that's a plus. Research report 4. Well, 015D has died much sooner than I expected while I was away on holiday. Dang it! Hi! I regret not being here, but I would estimate it would live much longer. Tina, the doctor, said nothing seemed to be wrong with the lungs, but the stomach had a circle hole about 2 feet narrow all the way through to the outside of the whale. This pretty much confirms a parasite that caused death. Whale! So is this a live whale, or is this a dead whale? I'm going to hope it's alive. What kind of screwed up castle is this? It's like, oh, it's too dark to see. I can see numbers! I'm guessing I just gotta find some kind of book or something. I like water. I'm quite parched, but I think the water. Oh, there's danger, high water pressure. Do you have a door just for danger, high water pressure? What? Do I have to get like a scuba suit and like fill the room up? It's irritating. Then I'm gonna die. Mermaids are gonna rip out my giblets. Research report 3. Whale 015A is still alive, but gets into fits of thrashing and is surfing more often than normal. I think there may be a problem with his lungs, but I don't have any tools that allow me to check without dying. Is there a 2-foot circular hole in it? I will have to allow it to die before it was causing him to do an opposite. What? Ah! Bill for his strange small bite marks. They appear from another swan. They're surging with his head there. And even rose around zero. All about 5 feet from the bottom of the stomach. So, we're gonna, like, run out of stuff? Or fuel? Ah! Something else I'd like to comment is how I think this game is different animating styles. Excerpt 4132, and then I watched carefully as the sea rose above the sky, casting waving shadows over the wall. I saw the silhouettes of creatures both familiar and forgotten, and suddenly I find myself falling off with swords and ocean darkness. I wonder if 4132 is the one code. I'm holding it by its like bottom. It's got a mushroom on top of it. This noise is weird though, and I feel like something bad is gonna happen. I also would like to ask, why am I using this when I have a flashlight? I mean, if I ran out of batteries, just tell me, I'll accept it. But since I have nothing to go on, I'm just going to assume that there's no reason. That's basically it. Okay. 4132. Called it. Keep it up. The research facility is now in dire need of more engineers. We have a whole block that has flooded and some vital staff are missing. Define missing dead. Oh well. I sure actually have no idea where I need to go. Alright, this is one of the spots for the whales. Yeah, parasite is a cause of death. Well, maybe it's just a predator. A small predator. What could be a small predator for a whale, Maximum? The water level is too high. Well, we need to find a way to get to engineering, I guess, and lower the water level. Is this engineering? Okay, this isn't engineering. There we go. This one. Max shows his genius navigational skills. And by that I mean, has anyone seen One Piece? You know, this is just the video of me making endless references. Anyone seen One Piece? Do you know who Zoro is? Well, Zoro has zero sense of navigation. I'm just about as bad. More whales are being shipped to the... Oh, yeah. Wait, what? Really, though. So we have a mansion on top of a whatchamacallit facility. Oh. I hear a girl or an animal or something sing to me, pleading that I come outside my locked room and let the sweeping waves comfort me. I don't know about you, lady, but sweeping waves doesn't exactly comfort me. That's not something that I look at and go, oh yes, sweeping waves, Iron Sister. It's like, ah yes, I just love it when I get slapped in the face by the ocean repeatedly. Ow! I have a bad feeling. It's a mermaid, right? Yeah? We're all in agreement, right? It's a mermaid, right? Maybe it can't kill me unless I'm in the water. Okay. I forgot. In this game, I can't jump. Okay, so. Huh? Okay, I don't hear anything. Go. All steps can only end for no proof, so I remain here resisting the call for my help, but I will remain as long as I can. Don't open the door. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there's only one thing I can do. Whatever you do, don't open that door. There seems to only be one option. And I think I know what it is. I think you do too. Oh, please don't. Let's open the door. Max, why? You know, she doesn't look particularly lovely. I'm just gonna throw that thought out there. I don't hear singing. I thought there was singing. Alright, have a nice day. No, I don't think I need to look around here first! What, do I have to, like, try to talk to her? Excuse me, ma'am, can you please rip out my throat? Gabby, came me. Dude, I don't want to rip out her throat. Or, excuse me, ma'am. Oh, well, oh, okay. Now, clearly, the only way to proceed is if you let a mermaid rip out your throat. Obviously. Now, obviously, that's just the best thing to do in this situation. I agree. I don't know if actually standing on boxes helps. I'm just gonna pretend it does. It makes me feel better if it does. I'm actually surprised. If I wasn't dyslexic. How fast I'm moving in the water. I mean, I don't know about you guys, but this looks like pretty deep water. Like, I don't know how tall I am, but if I had to wager a guess, it's at least a yard deep. Oh crap. Okay. I'm not in the water. It also appears to only really, like, recognize where I am as I'm in the water, which I thought was interesting to code. That or maybe it just moves very quickly and it only moves when I'm in the water, so. Maybe it's not as hard to code as I think it is. I don't know, coding is difficult. I mean, once you know it, it's like knowing the language, but, getting the hang of it, getting the thought process, remembering all the different things you can do. Have I said yet that I'm glad that my sprint came back, despite, Spooky's gift? I'm actually probably also being, like, way, safer than I need to be about it. That's also just because I don't feel like going through the, one room again. Has every 100 had that? Oh, it's... she's still so there. I kind of wish she would sing. I know you're thinking, why? It's like, just why? It's like, well, because it's a mermaid, right? They're talking about, like, ah! She's a Vaporeon. She is made of water. We are fighting a Vaporeon. Vaporeons are cool. I like Vaporeons. Never used one. I should do that someday. Okay. Do a run of Pokemon in old- Ah! What? No! Nonsense! I thought she had to come through the door! She's like, ah, gotcha, study! Hopefully she doesn't, like, pull me down or something. That would suck. Or maybe she's, like, being really stealthy. This is interesting though, I like this. Oh, no. Ah, whew. Alright, sorry. I thought I was on the box. I was like, oh, no. Oh! Nonsense! At least come from where there was only one of you. There's supposed to only be one of you. Here's like, I come from the side now. No, you come from the same door I went through. That's called logic. Oh. Yeah, she moves way faster than me in the water, I bet. Which is why, if anything, I need to use these boxes more to make sure I got enough sprint. Difficulty-wise, though? Not that bad. I'm more concerned thinking that she's going to, drag me down or something. Because let's be honest, how much effort would it take for someone to reach on top of this box and grab me? The number probably rhymes with none, and it's not one, and it doesn't have, it's not, 21 either. The answer's none. It would take, no... Ah! Nonsense. I forgot she's towards the left. Am I in the water? Yeah. Personally, if I made this level, I'd make it so that, you lose a lot of sprint in the water, because it's water, you know? So, basically, I'm saying I'd ramp up the difficulty. That's all I'm really saying. But don't get me wrong, it's still cool, I like it. It's just kind of strikes me... Oh, she's gonna flank me. Too fast for you. Can't flank an enemy you can't catch. Suck it. You're not gonna make a 2 foot... Oh, no. Almost hit it again. You're not gonna make a 2 foot in diameter hole in me and eat me. It strikes me that it's oh, we couldn't see anything wrong, not with the tools that we have. Oh, cool. Sir, there is a 2 foot diameter hole in that whale. Correct me if I'm wrong. Correct me if I'm wrong. But I think you don't need tools to see a 2 foot diameter hole into the lung, or stomach, or whatever it said. Either way, wouldn't there also be all sorts of blood gushing out, and food and stuff, and wouldn't the animal be, I don't know, dead? I think these aren't very good doctors. You know, I joke that I'm a doctor, however I do not have a doctorate, so, yeah, but... I don't think you need a doctor to say, there's a 2 foot hole. I think something killed it. Max, did the report say that it's up? Okay, so I don't know if that was Squidby or Squidgy or what, but I'm gonna pretend it wasn't and just keep running. That was Squidgy. Yeah, I officially have named all jump scares. Okay, they have names individually, but if I have to use a blanket name, it's Squidgy. Okay, there it is. Go. Go. We're good. Back. What was that? Ah, no, not this. Ah. Well, you know, if it has to be with anyone. Alright, buddy, let's go. Alright, follow me. Good boy. Good doggy. I should give you a name. I'm gonna call you Oracle. Yeah, your name is Oracle. I don't know why. Maybe it's like Orifus. I don't know. Just a real blanket term. Oracle. Hey, look, fire. Look, Oracle, fire. He's like, look, Oracle, fire. I'm going to eat you! Well, crap, Oracle. Maybe you should quit being a... Look, fire, Oracle! Look at it! Come on, Oracle. Oracle, stop that! Look, I'm with you, okay? He's like, no, I don't want to go... Oh, come on, Oracle. Come on. Let's go. So, Oracle, tell me about yourself. Do you want to go on record saying that, Oracle? So I'll take that as a yes. Stop that, Oracle! Behave! Bad Oracle! I'm not gonna hit you with a newspaper though, because if I do that, you're gonna open up your chest and eat me, so. Get over here, Oracle! I do, get out of here! Oh, what, dude? See, there, Oracle, put that down! Put down your stomach lining! Stop it, Oracle! Oracle's like, I saw what you did with the whales. What'd I do with the whales? You killed them. No, I didn't! The mermaid did! Oh, yeah, the mermaid did. So I'm guessing you didn't, like, bite a 2-foot in diameter hole into them? No. No, Oracle, I didn't do that. Because I can't breathe underwater. Or bite 2-foot diameter holes into whales. And Oracle's like, well, I'm so sorry. Yeah, you know, my apologies that I didn't think you could do. I need to give Oracle a voice.
My apologies, I didn't think you could do that.
And that's like a terrible voice. All right. Come on, Oracle. Come on, Oracle. Follow me. Follow me to greatness, Oracle. We're almost there. It's been a long journey, Oracle. We've had our good times and our. Ah, stop that. We've had our good times and our bad times, and you're one of the bad times. But we're almost home free. Come on, Oracle, follow me so I can take this candle and ram it down your throat. I wouldn't ram it down your throat, though, because you're a bitch. Come on, Oracle. Come on, Oracle. Surprised they're not just like, everyone. That would suck. It's like, everyone at once! Well, if you think about it, some of them would be invalidated by each other. For example, the gooey guy and the guy with the scythe are almost the exact same, with the exception that the gooey guy floats, and I don't think the guy with the scythe floats. The deer would be of no consequence, except that one deer monster, I think, moves a little faster. I don't know if he floats, but he moves pretty fast. Once again, the poles, much the same way, you just run. So really, the only ones that would actually be of, like, true interest would be this guy, the puppet, and Cleavagely. Yeah, so Oracle, the puppet salesman, and Cleaverage, and yeah. Those would only be the three of interest, because essentially what you'd have to do is, you'd have to stay close enough to them. You have to stay close to them to not to set off this guy. You have to keep looking at him because of the puppet. What's with all the wooden supports? This place is made of stone. Should you have like stone supports or like steel or something? Oh, okay. He's like, oh, he's still coming. Okay, he's gone. Yeah, so you'd have to look at him. You'd have to look at him to stop the puppet. Like, find the exit, which is all wonky, and, short hallway. Look at him to keep the puppet off, stay close enough to him to keep Oracle off, and then still find the exit because of cleavage. So it's like, that's like the worst situation ever. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna make it. Better ingredients, better pasta. That's the power of the Home Depot. What? It's better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's. Pasta, I don't even know where that came from. Keep that blood pumping. That's the power of... I think that statement's actually correct. That's the power of Home Depot. You're not my power! You're not my real father! Once again, I'd like to question... Oh, I can hold it at the ready! Power slash! Spooky, you need to get some oil on this crap. Once again, I'd like to question... I lost my train of thought. He was like, I'd like to question the, something... words? I'd like to question what in the world this place is. Is any of this going to be explained? I'm sorry, Spigby. Sorry, spider. I'm sorry, Squidgy. It's for your own good. It had to be done, Squidgy. This is it. Thank you all for your help. Floor 1000. Yeah. What do you mean exit? We're like way underground. Well, this was a great idea. Trap. What's that cat? No, this is it. Look, see, I can't get through here. Dang it, GLaDOS, let me out. GLaDOS. What, do I just, like, walk forward? Walk forward into the beautiful hills? I don't see anything. What the? I knew it was glitching out. Vista Sky Fatal Error. Fake sky screen.
Congratulations.
Ha! Ah, there you are. Hi! Hi.
Oh!
Oh!
To prove your dedication.
He's like, huh. Oh, crap, you did it. Ooh, goody, I got an idea. Oh, man. This blows. What? Oh, there it is. Great. Well, I got an axe. That's not letting me use. I hate this song.
My mouse is on the screen, by the way.
Yeah, it is. Glitch? Okay, that was weird. I just kept hitting escape and it was just getting bluer. You guys saw that. Sure hope they let me use my axe. Don't let me sprint either. Sure hope this isn't like an actual glitch. Cause that means I'm gonna... have to redo floors and junk. What? Take to the dead. What? Oh, crap. Hey, you're that guy. Aw, man. Blood just went over my face. Zombies ate my neighbor style. I like that music. Sarah, can you explain to me what that was?
Make sure the axe.
That was cool. Sir, are you actually even doing anything? Whoa! Sir, are you actually doing anything? Oh, hey, I hit that on accident! Oh, I get it. So you're like Ganondorf. We have to play Fool's Volley. You're using like illusions and crap on me. Trying to mess. Yeah. Traps that'll kill me. Summoning minions, and then every now and then you're just gonna throw fire. Stop, zombie! Oh! The glitching is also throwing me. Oh, look now, there's little people. Die, little person. Die, little person. He's gonna charge a fireball. Oh, snap! Snap, crackle, pop! I guess. I'll let you live this time. I'll let you off easy. These are some really slow attacks. I mean, they're cool and they're siege-erific, and I think those are eyeballs, but, oh, this gets me the most, this attack. That attack's like, dude. Yeah, Bill and Jim never died for some reason. Ah, what? How did claw me? It was a fireball! I hit you, I just got dodge wrestling. Ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong. You dead yet? Oh, he's really mad now. Oh look, 6 eyeballs. Max can't take this seriously. It's so weird. I want that dramatic music in the beginning back. That music was awesome. Dude. That's stepping it up. Gotcha. You guys hang tight. Just axe storm. Oh yeah, this is stepping it up. Having like the 15 hands come towards me. Oh, that was freaky. Ah, crap, those hands. Ah, screw that. I'm out. Alright. Now, since swinging my axe, I can never, like, max out. Ah, there we go, see? You can just swing out. Like, come towards my axe storm. I'm gonna kill you. There, what if I hit you with your own thing? Oh, he's not affected. Get this blood out of my face, man. I gotta get the hand out. Gotta keep moving. Gotta stay pretty. Gotta keep dancing. Oh, that almost hit me. There, hit you with the fireball. Yeah! Oh, I'm still going. She's like, wow, you're a sick monster. Hi!
Congratulations!
Yeah!
It was interesting watching you swing your axe around like that.
Yes, sick
you
monster.
Make a fine specimen.
What? Bad ending. Did you really think it was going to end seriously? What? Bad ending. To watch you swing your axe like that. I'm like, what do you mean? I was just trying to kill him. Yeah, phone gal. I'm suspicious. I didn't even hear the deer lord. What? Okay. Special thanks to PewDiePie, Markiplier, Game Grumps, Harshy Critical, Boogie, Hot Pepper Gaming, and everyone who supported us. So I guess I got the bad ending. Guess I'm a new fine specimen? I don't see how what I did was wrong. I only killed things or attacked things that tried to kill me, so. Max the best. Alright, hang on. I saw that, by the way. Alright, let's see. Skip to. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. I like it. Hang on a second, let me just check something. Alright, so, looking it up, apparently every time you killed, unnamed specimens, for example, deer, and the cutouts increase this counter, and if the counter goes over 20, I think it's like 4 for every unnamed specimen and 1 for every cardboard cutout. If it increases to over 20, you get the bad ending. Sorry. Sorry, I'm just a psychopathic killer, I guess. If you get it under, you get the good ending, which apparently you die anyway. Like, you get, the ceiling, like, falls and crushes. She's like, oh, that's so tragic, but it's okay. Now you're part of my ghost army. And then there's a secret ending. Apparently, remember those brains we randomly saw? I didn't do anything to them because I thought they would kill me. But apparently, if you examine them and get a code, you'll take those codes to arcade machines, and the arcade machine that's always black, you input that code in, you see a scene, which I'm not gonna show here, but apparently it involves like the origin of Spooky, so I'm gonna encourage you guys to play to go and find that. Overall though, I'll admit, some of it kinda droned on. Some of it was kind of irritating. Some of the mechanics were like, ah, oh, this stinks, I don't like this. But overall, I think it was fun. I personally really enjoyed it. I liked how the game was cute, but was able to still be scary. I mean, I think it was best. I think the highlight to this game was when cute things would scare you. I mean, like, the horrific monsters, they were well made and everything. And, like, how they kind of set up each individual area. It was like, the mermaids killing whales. There's a fast food place and people keep eating. There's a, you know, like, we're on a space station. They didn't say space station, but you get the idea. It was interesting seeing them build, like, each of these individual areas. I wish they did more with it, though. I wish it made more sense. But granted, this game doesn't take itself seriously, which I think is about a lot of the charm of it. Overall, definitely recommend it. Show it to your friends. Support the person. As I said before, there's going to be a link in the description to the person's page and stuff. Yeah, it's free on Steam. $10 for the soundtrack, I want to say. Definitely go and support Leg Studios, because it's silly, and it's silly, it may not be perfect, but I personally really enjoyed it. So, if you guys have a suggestion for a different indie game, something you want me only to play one of, or like a mini-series or something, hit me up in the comments, tell me down there, and I'll definitely look into it. I have no problem with that. So, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you then.
We're good.
We're kicking butt, taking names. Oh, joy, we're. Look at me. We're good. Oh, the mangle. Mangle change. I don't know. Is that enough? Ah, disappeared. Oh, wait. What the crap's that? Is that. Okay, I'm gonna use the same logic that I used before. I'm just not gonna look at him. Get back.
No idea.
No! I meant to hit the mask! I misclicked!
Was that the puppet? What's it?
What's it? Get the crap out!
First flash scene. 1, 2, 3!
Apple!